This nigga so by mine.
Pupsplace, and today I am in my makeup section. I use air quotes because this isn't like my makeup section, but right now it has the best lighting and it's dark outside. But I thought, since today is my filming day, that I would do a back to school sixth grade makeup routine. So let's get started. Alright, so I just put my hair up and my little bangs up, and the first step is we're going to prime our face, or whatever, like you could use lotion or primer. I have e.l.f., but really whatever you use to prime your face. So I'm just going to put a squirt of that on the back of my hand and just apply it all to my face. And of course you can't forget the ears and your neck, because your ears want to be primed as well as your neck and face. All right, now I am nice and primed. What I would usually do is apply foundation, and I apply a nice like coat of foundation, but since this is school, we really just want our face one like even color at first. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to get my foundation and get it on my beauty blender, or first on my finger, and apply it to my face lightly. And when I say lightly, I mean lightly. Then I'm going to clean off the back of my hand and I'll be right back. Alright, so I cleaned my hand and finished putting foundation on my ears and neck. So now we're just going to get a dampened beauty blender or whatever brush you have and start blending it. My technique is I dab the dampened beauty blender on my face, and then sometimes every now and then if there's like a spot that dried up a little bit, then I'll lightly drag it down. But I also got this new brush set. This one is for foundation, so I'm going to take it out and show you guys. This one is the foundation brush, and I haven't used it out on makeup yet, so this is exciting. It's very soft, I noticed, and I love that, because who doesn't like a nice soft brush? Now you really gotta blend it out around your ears, especially if you have short hair and you're like pulling back your hair, where you could see your ears nice and proudly. You really gotta blend it in on your ears, your forehead, and your neck, because you can't forget to give your neck some love, or else you'll have two different colors on your face, and that's just not ideal. So I'm going to finish blending this in, and I'll see you guys when I'm done. All right, so I just finished blending in my foundation, and let me say, this is a really great brush. It blended in smoothly, and I barely had to use my beauty blender, and my beauty blender is like my lifesaver, and I always use it, so that's really surprising. Anyway, the next step is, you guessed it, concealer, but we're not gonna go harsh on the concealer or anything. We're gonna go nice and light. So let me grab my mirror real quick. All right, so I got my mirror, and I'm just going to check and see where all my blemishes are and stuff like that. So I have a few down here by my chin, one by my nose, and one on my forehead right here. Then I'm just going to do under my eyes, and I'm not gonna do what I usually do, where you do the T down your nose and your forehead, a triangle, and basically like all over your face. I'm not gonna do that because it's a light, natural look for school. So I'm going to get a little dot where my blemishes are, and then the dark circles. So like I always do, I am going to do it in a triangle shape, because that covers it better when you blend it in for some reason. Don't know why, don't ask why, but as long as it covers it, I'm fine with it. So I got one eye done and all of my blemishes have concealer on them. So this is what the other eye will look like. So let me just do that real quick. Then we can move on to blending. Alright, so I have both eyes done and my blemishes are covered, so now I just need to get my beauty blender or my concealer brush or my other concealer brush, which is, my other concealer brush is my foundation brush. So I think I'm going to use this and my beauty blender because they worked out great for me last time. So let me just get started on doing my blemishes. And I'm going to do a few blemishes down here. And then the rest of the blemishes I'm going to do with this brush to test it out and see how it blends with the concealer, because the concealer is a different product. And so far, it looks like it's doing pretty well. Looks like my blemish is nice and covered. Can't even see it. That's nice. Everyone likes that. Now I'm going to do one eye with my beauty blender and my bristle, like my little fluffy brush, like I usually do, and on the other eye, I'm going to use only this special brush. So let's get started.
Could dress up to get love, but guess what? I'm never gonna be that girl who's living in a Barbie world. Could wake up and make up and play dumb, pretending that I need a boy who's gonna treat me like a toy. I know the other girlies wanna wear expensive things with diamond rings, but I don't wanna be the puppet that you're playing on a string. This queen don't need a king. I don't know what you've been told, but this guy right here's gonna rule the world. Yeah, that is what I'm gonna be, because I wanna be. No, I don't wanna sit still, look pretty. You get off on a 9-to-5 dream of picket fence.
Alright, so I did my face. This is the side that I use this brush, and this is the side that I use my beauty blender and my fluffy brush, and I actually like this one so much better that I ended up blending this one and again with this brush. So the next step is we are going to use this little elf. So I just finished blending in my concealer and everything, and I liked this side so much better, which is the one I use with this brush, that I actually redid this eye and re-blended it with this right here. I'm pretty well blended and my dark circles are pretty well covered. And the next step we're going to do is, for the first time in my life, the first time I was messing around with makeup. But second time is now, and I'm going to use some bronzer in this e.l.f., which is a nice, cheap product if you're on a budget. This e.l.f. highlight and bronzer duo. So I'm going to actually get, since I didn't have a brush for it, this little set comes with 3 brushes, and one of the brushes is for contour. So I'm going to use this brush for my bronzer, and I'm not going to cut this clip or anything because I've never used bronzer before and I want you guys to be the first to see me do it. So how do I do this? All right, you guys have to tell me in the comments what the difference is between bronzer and concealer. Oh, wow. Yeah, that's there. All right, this better blend well. Good thing my forehead is usually covered by my bangs, but I haven't been wearing my bangs as like bangs. I've been wearing them as side bangs, so I haven't been wearing them as normal bangs. I've said bangs a lot already, and this clip barely started. So I am pretty impressed with this blending, actually. Ooh, what? Am I doing all right? Like, because we don't want our face to be flat or anything. No one wants a flat face. That's not friendly or anything. No one likes that. What? The heck? Am I doing all right? Guys, comment down in the comments. Am I doing my bronzer right or what? Because I think you put it in the place of concealer. I've never used concealer before. Like once when I was playing around with makeup, but that doesn't count because I put glitter on my nose. Like on purpose, I went like this and splatted glitter on my nose because I was just playing around with makeup. But I've never really used these things like properly, and I realized my mirror's upside down. No, I think I gotta get some more product. Well, I know I gotta get some more product, but I'm going to put it by my cheeks. I hope I didn't pick up too much product. Because no one wants to be flat. So under my cheekbone, I think. Is that it? I mean, I want to be colorful. I want to be a nice colorful lady. But I don't, oh no. What happened? It's too strong. Too strong. Look who came out of the cage. Aww. She sleeps in a little crate. Regan, the little bulldog. She sleeps in a little crate and she's out of the crate right now, but she walked in for some reason. Like she didn't make a mess or anything, because most of the time she walks in if she made a mess. Or she's just tired. I think she's just tired. But right here, I think I blended that already. Does my face not look flat? I hope not. Woo! So this is what I'm doing right here. I'm gonna use a little more product. Might ruin it, might not. I'm gonna use a little more product on this side of my face. I think this looks pretty good. What do you guys think? Comment down below. I'm asking you guys to comment down below with a lot of things. Crazy man. I'm not a man. Why did I just say that? All right, actually, that looks pretty good. Now I'm gonna finish this side of my face, go like this. I'm gonna do this nose as well, and then I'm going to do this side off camera. So I'm also going to do my jawline, or no, I won't do my jawline, because should I do my jawline? I'll do my jawline. I'll do it like a crazy person, and I'll do it very like light and gentle, because that's the look we're going for today, because you know, school doesn't want you wearing a clown full of face and makeup, which I don't really want anybody to wear that much makeup, because it's bad for your skin and everything. But wearing makeup's fun. A lot of girls think it's a priority to me to wear it, but I wear it for fun because nobody needs makeup. They just like makeup. And that's what guys don't understand. Well, at least a lot of guys don't. Most guys just believe that girls do makeup because they don't like the way they look, or because they don't like themselves, or they do it to impress guys. And that is completely wrong, and we only do it because we want to. So now I just did my jawline. Don't know how it looks because it's very dark in here because it's nighttime. But now I'm just going to do this side of my face. So I'm going to get a little more product on the brush. And I'm going to put it on this side right here under the cheekbone. That's where I think that's where you're supposed to put it, hopefully. This is what it looks like so far. I know I don't look like a pancake, I think, which is good, because I'm actually putting color and everything on it. If this turns out well, I might use bronzer in my everyday look, or just like in general, I might just use it all. I'll just use all the bronzer in one day, just so I look bronzed. I love doing this, it's the best. All right, so this cheek needs a little more product, because I'm looking a little flat, looking like Flat Stanley over here, and no one wants to look like Flat Stanley, except Flat Stanley, because he loves himself, which is good. And I'm kind of using the bottom view right here as well, because that has a nice angle of my cheek from the bottom view with the best light. But other than that, I'm using the top one. I think this looks all right. Ooh, update, soon I'm going to be getting, my dad's playing ball with Gus upstairs, but I'm going to be getting a nice tall tripod. So, because a lot of the videos that I film are in places without a table, and we don't want that, because without a table, it makes it hard for me to find something. Now I'm going to do my nose, and I am excited to do my nose because, I don't know, I feel it's pretty hard or something like that. I don't know, I'm scared, but I think it's going to be fun. Lightly blow on it, get the extras off. Alright, we're good. Here's Regan right here, ruining my audio. Hi, Reg. So she's down there. So I'm going to do the side of my nose. Oh no. Oh well. Too late now, already started. I'm gonna do this side of my nose. Wow, that's a lot of product on my nose. That's great. Now I'm gonna slope over my nose like this. Because who doesn't want a slopey nose? I know this is for contour, but you guys really need to tell me what the difference is between contour and bronzer. But so far, my nose is very, very, very bronzed. Like, extremely bronzed. Now, I'm going to get most of the product off, and I'm just going to use my arm, because why not? That's what I usually do if I need to clean a brush, like, quickly. And now I'm just going to blend it in. So far, I think this look is going pretty good. I don't look cakey because there's not a lot of product on me, which is great for school because you don't want to be cakey face in school, or you don't want to be cakey face ever, really. But this is going hopefully good so far. Yeah, she's just chilling in the cage now. All right. That looks like a properly bronzed nose, I think. Never used bronzer before. Watch a lot of makeup videos. James Charles, where you at? I think that's a nicely bronzed nose. Finally. All right, the next thing we're gonna do is clean the brush and put it away because she needs to rest. Now I'm going to get my favorite. Which brush is it? I have two of the same brushes, but they're slightly different. It's this one. I'm gonna use this. And this is a stronger highlighter that I use most of the time, and I'll finger swatch it for you. See, very strong highlighter. And for school, you want to be strong and you want to be glowing, but not that much. Look what came off with a single finger swatch. Now, if I finger swatch this one, it's a lighter color, and it's nice and glowy, but it won't be too bright. And this is what came off of this one. And see, you can barely see it. So I'm going to use this one. Like, you can barely see it on the paper and everything, but you can obviously see it on skin with my finger swatch that you saw. So let's see how it looks on my cheeks. All right, so I got some product and I'm just going to dust off and then go for the cheek. Right above the cheekbone, it's where the hollow roads. Little musical for you guys. Alright, I think something's there. No, that's on both sides. It's just my greasy skin. Alright, well, we'll try that again. Maybe she just needs a little help. Maybe she just needs a different brush, who knows? Oh, crazy. Right. Now we're not dusting off. I didn't dust off this time. That's nice. Yeah, this one's definitely better. That's nice. I think someone's there. Or is that just my skin? I don't know. She's confusing me. I think someone's there. All right, maybe I just need a different brush. How about that? We'll just use a different brush. We'll use this brush that I used for contour because I cleaned it off. Got a little tissue right here and nothing came on. Like came off on the tissue, which is good. All right, so a lot of product came off on this one. Now we're just gonna dust it a little bit and go in. Okay, she's there. Guys, you see her? Woo! She is there and she's fierce. Oh, she's making a comeback with this brush. Yeah, it was just the brush I was using. For some reason, it wasn't good enough for this highlight. Alright, there she is. See, this cheek is so much less glowy. Well, this one is shining. Alright, this cheek is beautiful and I am in love with it. Now, I'm going to do the other cheek. And let's see how this one turns off. Oh, let's see how this one turns up. Alright, product. That's nice. Ready? Product, nice product. See, you could see like the layer of product just right here. Now we're just gonna dust off and go for this side. Huh, okay. Someone's there. Who's there? Working with it? A little bit. All right, now we're just going to start moving up right here, just a little. This cheek is way more glowy. This cheek can't have all the fame. I'm just gonna blend that in a little more up here. All right. Now, right here. Don't wanna make one cheek glowier and more fabulous than the other. I gotta make both fabulous. All right. I think this cheek is done as well. I think both of them are glowing and I love that. And I'm actually going to do that with the tip of my nose as well. So I got a little bit of product. I'm just going to dab it on my nose. Doo-doo-doo. And there it is. Wow. Cupid's bow as well. Mm-hmm. I love it. She is shining. Watch. If I can reflect the light off there and onto my face, then I guess that would work out, wouldn't it? Yeah, something's there, and I am loving that something. Now, what I should have done first, but stupidly not, is blush before highlight. But I'm going to do a light layer of blush to make it look like we're happy or blushing. I'm going to do it nice and under the highlight. Kind of in the middle of the bronzer and highlighter. Just a nice little layer. And then on this side as well. Nice and soft. So I'm done with the cheek section. Yay. So this little duo is great. A nice cheap bronzer. It's not like cheap in a bad way, but a nice affordable, I should say. Nice affordable bronzer that works pretty well, I think. I mean, I saw a lot of products. And then a nice and simple highlight, which is perfect for school, and especially e.l.f. is great. Like, e.l.f. is fantastic when it comes for products that are overpriced and they're affordable and they give off a nice natural, or they could be unnatural, like they could be glam if you want, but you just need a little extra product for that. But nice, affordable, like little product that, as I said again, affordable, which is fantastic if you're on a budget, which I am. I mean, I was, but now we're moving on to eyes. So with the eyes, I'm going to get a little bit of concealer and dab it on the lid, both lids. There. They're on my lids. I'm just gonna blink a few times. for no apparent reason, to see if it spread, which it did. All right, now I'm going to get my, where is it? Here. I'm going to get my brush and just lightly blend that in. Or actually, I'm going to go all in with my finger because it makes sure that it's not too fluffy and just gets it blended for sure. I'm going to use that concealer a little bit as a highlight for the brow bone, even though I don't really want to highlight my brow bones because my brows are not done properly. But here it is, nice and blended. Everybody likes a nice blended concealer base. A nice concealer base to blend. And here we go, once more, with e.l.f. This is kind of like an older book that I have, but it's e.l.f. Beauty Book Collection. It's a little old, but it works like a charm, so. We're going to grab a little brush right here. This is the brush I usually do. And we're gonna start off with more of a natural color, which is the bottom one right here. It's a nice, simple brown tone, and we're going to start off putting that on the entire lid as a color base. So bottom one for sure. So that's a nice base right here. Next, I'm going to try out, haven't used, but I'm going to try out this eyeshadow brush, with the collection that I have, which 100% obsessed with these. They are fantastic, love them. They are my bae. So I'm going to get another color. It's a little bit lighter, and it's this one on the very, very top. A light color. Get some product off. Get some product off of there. Blow it off, and you can see some product on the brush. Now I'm going to go in the crease and just blend it out all up in that crease. There. Now I'm going to... My little mirror almost fell, and what a broke, and caused me 7 years of bad luck. Now I'm going in with my little Claire's cheap palette. It's hollow, or it's either hollow or unicorn skin. No, I think it's hollow. Christine, don't come after me, or holosexuals, don't come after me because it's a scary world that I'm entering. But I have this little palette from Claire's eyeshadow palette. And I'm going to use this right here, this shade. And I'm going to use it with this brush. Then I'm going to clean up my arm. And apply it in the middle and kind of corner of my eye. Corner and blend up with that crease, kind of. Go. That's an eye. I'll clean it up. But it looks pretty good so far. I'm just going to get this for extra blending. Alright, so it's nice and blended there. Then I'm going to experiment. Crazy word, but yes. And I'm going to clean this brush real quick and get, wait for it, gulp, a black shade and mix it in with this brown. So black and mix it in. And I'm just going to do that on my hands real quick. Back of my hand. Make some nice little shade. I'm going to get some, okay, I'm going to do something scary. I'm going to claw out a little bit of product, which breaks my heart, but gotta do it. Just a little bit more. And apply that to the back of my hand. Some fell off of my shirt, that's great. And I'm going to clean the back of this. And then I'm going to get the lighter, like the lightest brown shade. The lightest dark brown shade, I should say. And get a little bit of that. And apply that to the back of my hand as well. Preferably more brown than black. But you can do you. Depends on how intense you want it to be. Now I'm just going to sort of mix that up on the back of my hand. Like that, where it's a light black shade. Then I'm going to get that all on my brush. Go to my eye, close to my eyelashes. And then smudge it. To make a nice little waterline kind of thing. And I am missing one key thing. I'll be right back. So the thing was black eyeliner. Scary, but this one is liquid and this one is a stick. Now I'm going to get a little bit of this stick. This scares me a lot, but I'm doing it. And I am scarefully going to smudge it by my eyelashes. And it doesn't scare me that it's gonna hurt anything. I'm not scared about that anymore. But I'm scared that I'm going to mess up my entire look. All right, I need to doubt a little more because I'm terrified. All right. All right, there's a wing going downwards. Wasn't expecting that, but it happened anyway. Whew. Now I'm going to get this little brush, great for smudging. And lightly blend it. Okay, not that bad. I'll probably clean up this section a little bit where there's the little like line that I did, the little mini downwards wing. But other than that, that looks fine. Watch, let me reflect some light or something. There, spotlight. Not bad, and that highlight is glowing. Great, that's good. So I'm going to do the same thing on the other eye, and then we're on to mascara. So I'll see you in a second. All right, so I finished my other eye, and now it's time for mascara, and then lipstick or lip gloss, and then we are done with this look. So the product for eyelashes I'm going to be using here today is a simple Claire's mascara. And then this eyelash color. Now I'm going to curl my eyelashes real quick. And then I decided to use the Claire's mascara because it's not as strong as the other mascara that I have. And we're going for more of a natural look today because we're going to school with this makeup on and we don't want to be full glam. Unless you want to. That's based on you. But here is what the wand looks like. And it curves up like this to get more into like the inner part of your eye with the mascara. So here I'm applying one thin coat on the top of my lashes. Well, on the top lashes. And then one little layer on the bottom. And this is the final mascara look. It's very simple, but it does make your lashes, it does make them pushed up more, as does the eyelash curler, and it opens up your eyelashes. I mean, it opens up your eyes more to make you look more awake and not asleep, because you're waking up at 6 a.m. or that's the time I wake up at. So that's what the eyelashes look like, and the eyes are done. So the next part is I have all kinds of lipsticks and lip glosses here, but you can also use chapstick. Chapstick works really good because you don't have to reapply it. You're less likely to get your hair stuck to it, and you won't get any crusties in the corner of your lips. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to get my favorite liquid lipstick and do a very, and I mean very, thin coat of that all over my lips. Just to give my lips some color. There. Now I have some extra color on my lips, because for some reason when I wake up in the morning, I am a ghost. More of a ghost, because I'm a ghost all the time. But I'm more of a ghost and my lips are the same color as my face, and that's just not ideal. So the next thing we're going to do is we're going to get one of these three little lip glosses. I'm going for the second most natural one, so this would be the most natural one, and we don't want that. We don't want the orange one, because that's really out there. So we're going for the pinkish, more like lip tone. And it's very noticeable, because you want it to be noticeable, but you don't want it to be too noticeable. So this one's pretty nice, adds a nice gloss to this lipstick for sure. But then again, you don't want to add too much because, one, your hair will get stuck to it. Two, there's a possibility you'd get crusties in the side of your mouth. And three, I don't have three, just those two. So now this thin coat of lipstick, the gloss will apply nicely. And there we go. So the gloss is on, and here is my face. If you could see my face, a little shadowy. The eyes are nice and done. Everything is bronzed and highlighted and blushed, so we don't look like flat Stanley. That's not our goal here. It's a very nice and natural makeup look, and I'm very happy with it. I would gladly go to school with this, which I actually might tomorrow, because today is... Wait, I actually might Monday, because today's Saturday. But this, you bronze your face to make sure your face isn't flat Stanley. Then you put blush on your face to make sure that, like, your face isn't one color, same with the bronzer. And to make it look like you're blushing, and just add a tiny bit more color. And then you add some highlight, you know, just because you want to glow up your life. So I'm going to put my hair down, and then I'll show you what the final look is. Alright guys, so I put my hair down, it's all done, and this is the final look. I think it's a nice natural look for school, and it can also be an everyday, but it's really nice and natural. I have it where you can tell you're wearing makeup, but you're not going all glam because it's school and you don't want all eyes on you, because it's kind of embarrassing. But unless you do, then you can do whatever you want with your makeup. This is just a suggested look, and thank you, Elf, so much for being cheap, having a nice natural look to it. This bronzer and this highlighter really saved my life, because I didn't have a bronzer, and the highlighter that I usually use is way too strong to use for school, or way too strong to use for a natural look. So thank you so much, Elf. A lot of the products that I used today was from Elf. And thank you guys so much for watching. Don't forget to follow me on Instagram at RosieRose10. Follow all my pets. The links will be in the description. Don't forget to follow me on Facebook and follow me on Snapchat. One more thing, don't forget to subscribe to Pups Place. Click the red subscribe right here and then click the bell right here to get all my video notifications. And if you're on a mobile device, you can do that down below. Thank you guys so much for watching and I'll see you later. Bye. That's a wrap.